with me.
Amen.
Hook up with me.
Amen.
Join me.
Amen. Now, the problem with that is he went to the cross. Y'all like that heaven side, but you don't like that cross side. Jesus said, everybody's got a cross back. Take up my cross, he said, and follow. He said, yoke up with me. Take my yoke upon me and do what? Some of us know the history, biology, politics, the circumference of a circle. We know pi. We know linear equations. We know everything about Jesus. You know Einstein's theory of relativity. You know everything. But you don't know nothing about Jesus. He says, after you turn to him, you need to learn about it. He said, now, your first lesson, Jesus is going to want you to know I am meek and lowly in heart. He said, your first lesson is to learn about it. I ain't going to do you no harm. I'm meek. Now, he didn't say he's weak.
Yeah.
He just said, I'm meek.
Yeah.
And he said, I'm low key. My heart, I ain't going to do you no harm.
Amen.
You show me people who are meek and got a good heart, those are the folk I want to be around.
Yeah.
And he says, then you shall find what?
Rest.
Unto your soul. Folk are dying young.
Mm-hmm.
Folk are looking old.
Right.
Because they will never get the rest for their souls. So after you turn to Christ, you need to learn about Christ. And then you'll have a yearning. Some folk learn about him, but they ain't got no yearning about him. They got a thirst and a hunger for everything with Jesus. Listen, Matthew said in Matthew 5 and 6, Jesus said, they that hunger and thirst after righteousness shall be filled. For you need to have an insatiable thirst and yearning for Jesus. It always amazes me how folk love everything and everybody but Jesus.
Right.
Listen, we started worshiping at 11 o'clock. It's 10 and 1. And some of you right now, you've been too long already. Because you don't have no hunger for this.
No? Right. Yeah.
2 hours of church, too much for you. Mm-hmm. Where's your learning?
Mm-hmm.
Well, we ain't got no night service. Let's just stay in the free. Because they don't have that insatiable thirst and yearning. begin to learn about Christ. And then you begin to hear from God completely. Carl killed this. I heard a story, Carl, about an old man who was going to receive. Matter of fact, Deacon John Carl had ready to receive the Lord's need of rest in place. Stand up, Carl. This old man tells a story that he was home at night, decided he needed some milk from the store. And tell him, cut through that back alley and go to the store. On the way back home with milk, did you wonder if y'all cousin was stopping in the dark back alley and asked him for a light for a cigarette? The old man reached in his pocket, took out his lighter, and lit the young boy's cigarette. As soon as he lit the boy's cigarette, the boy ran off, ran down the alley. Old man thought it was peculiar, perplexed, but didn't think of it, went home. Next morning, he watches the news and hears that there's been a murder in his neighborhood. He hears and sees the address. The murder occurred in the same alley that he was in a few hours earlier. They see him. They see the victim's name and picture put up. The boy was murdered. And then a police announced they arrested the suspect for the murder. They put the picture up. And the picture is the same boy who he gave a light to a few hours earlier. He's now been arrested, charged with capital murder in the first degree. Oh man, realize I gave that boy a light in that same alley a few hours earlier. He's perplexed. Why did he rob me? Why did he kill me? Curiosity got the best of him, went down to the jail. He's an old man. Yes. The authorities, can I just talk to him a moment? And there he was in a room with a bulletproof glass between him and that young boy. He said, I saw you in that alley on last night and I gave you a light. And now he's been charged with murdering another person in that alley. What's up? The young boy said, let me be honest with you, old man. I planned to rob you. I planned to kill you. I was going to take your keys and go back to your house and take everything in your house. He said, but when you lit my cigarette, when you lit your light, I saw a big fella standing behind you. I saw a big old man standing behind you. He said, what about me? He said, no, sir. He said, when you lit your light, I said to you, you lit your light. Rest.